Hello, welcome. After so many videos about emulators, only a few have survived and already have builds available, namely Suyu and Sudachi. Suyu has been making progress with some new features, such as better mod management, additional content, cheats, and updates. Sudachi has already addressed minor issues like RAM memory leaks and reduced RAM consumption, both in its PC and Android versions. But the question is the actual performance already better than the latest version of Yuzu or even Ryujinx? That's what we're going to test in this video. I've selected 5 games that are the entry games for this platform, games that all fans will probably want to know about. All projects are running at native resolution, without any texture compression, without anti-aliasing filters, and all running on the same machine and under the same circumstances. All projects are also running with unlocked FPS only for benchmarking purposes. No one is going to play Mario Kart 8 at 250% speed, okay? There may be slight variations in ambient temperature or RAM consumption. The first test we're going to run is on Mario Kart 8 Deluxe. In none of the projects were there any graphical issues. You'll also notice that in most tests, Ryujinx will have worse performance, but that's due to its higher accuracy, as higher accuracy demands more hardware requirements. Here, the difference in reduced memory consumption that Sudachi brought is already noticeable. It consumes about 600 megabytes less than all other projects. If we're only comparing Yuzu derivatives, we have practically a technical tie. Pokémon Scarlet and Violet are the games with the most questionable optimization for Nintendo Switch. There have been several complaints, but there has been no improvement from the Pokémon company. On the contrary, it has been observed in past videos that there have even been texture downgrades. Unfortunately, posting exclusive content of this game doesn't last a week on the platform. At launch, the game only ran on Ryujinx. Over time, it started running on Yuzu, but only with the GPU accuracy set to normal. In the latest updates, this has been fixed, but there are still minor vertex explosions and distant objects. Here, Ryujinx continues to be the best project to play, with an average FPS higher than Sudachi, which comes in second. Interestingly, for the second time, Sudachi outperforms both Suyu and Yuzu, and once again, the difference in RAM usage is clearly evident. While these 500 to 600 megabytes may seem insignificant when using a PC, they can be a game changer when it comes to Android emulation, considering the range of devices available. Tomorrow, I'll be bringing a video in this style, but comparing the projects on Android. And the game you should definitely focus on, if you haven't already, is Super Mario Odyssey. For this test, we selected the most challenging scenario in the game, the Metro Kingdom. And here, I was surprised, after several comparisons between Yuzu and Ryujinx, with Yuzu always performing better, this time Ryujinx showed superior performance, with up to a 7 FPS difference compared to the latest version of Yuzu. However, as observed in most tested games, the low 1% is consistently worse on Ryujinx, suggesting that stutters when compiling shaders are more frequent here. Regarding the performance of Yuzu-based projects, we have practically a tie between Sudachi and Suyu, with Yuzu consistently occupying the last position again. I highlight once again the RAM savings in Sudachi. And folks, if you appreciate this type of practical comparison that requires a lot of work to be carried out, don't forget to leave your like and a comment so that the video reaches the widest possible audience and helps the channel grow. And if this is your first time here, consider subscribing for new updates. Now that you've left your like, I want to dive into a controversy that has sparked several discussions on this channel since the beginning. Let's go! Although there are differences between generations, Zelda Breath of the Wild is the same game on the Wii U and Nintendo Switch. The textures aren't better, the terrain quality isn't better, only the anti-aliasing of the base consoles and the resolution are differentiators on the Nintendo Switch. However, when it comes to emulators, where you control anti-aliasing and resolution, this doesn't make a difference. As for the customization of emulators and their features, Simu is light years ahead of any of the emulators released for the Switch. When the game was released in 2017, Simu was already capable of running it, while Nintendo Switch emulators were in their early coding stages. So, if your goal is to play this game, please use Simu. With that said, I know you're here to see the comparisons, so Simu will be set aside since it's already the best platform. Another point that needs to be clarified is that, for some reason, when loading the same save on Ryujinx, it wasn't raining. Therefore, the benchmark recorded here on Ryujinx should be disregarded, as it had an advantage over the other projects, since it didn't need to process rain effects and lighting changes. For this test, I'm using the 60 FPS patch. This patch doesn't support dynamic FPS, so any FPS rate below 60 will make the game slow, as you can see. Yuzu, before the release of Zelda Tears of the Kingdom, received several improvements focused on the engine used in this game, so in a head-to-head test with Ryujinx, it probably has an edge. Analyzing the results of the Yuzu-derived projects, this time Sudachi showed the worst performance. You'll notice that Sudachi has issues with this engine in the next game I'll test, which is Tears of the Kingdom. Sudachi simply has some problems, like vertex explosions and many freezes when compiling new shaders. It's important to note that before recording this video, I had already compiled shaders in all projects. As for Yuzu and Suyu, the performance is practically the same, a technical tie. But use Simu or I'll delete your League of Legends account, I'm serious. And lastly, one of the most recent standout releases, Zelda Tears of the Kingdom. The game was recorded with a mod to unlock the FPS. As I mentioned earlier, observe the problem Sudachi faces with this engine. Even using the same mods and settings in all projects, there are many issues with vertex explosions, especially when moving the camera, as well as higher VRAM consumption. We can immediately discard Ryujinx. In situations where it needs to render with the same effects as the other projects, using the Zelda engine, Ryujinx falls far behind. Sudachi performs better than expected, but also suffers from the vertex explosions already demonstrated. So, we have only two viable options, Yuzu and Suyu. Again, there's practically a technical tie between the two projects. In summary, if your current project is working well, there's no reason to switch to another project. Even though the data between the three Yuzu projects is compatible saves, shaders, DLCs, and updates, you can transfer all this data from one project to another without any issues. Regarding the most promising projects, due to RAM savings, I would opt for Sudachi for now. However, I acknowledge that Suyu has already made changes to the layout, improvements in managing game data, and even implemented the home menu. But considering that Sudachi has already achieved a difference of practically 7 FPS in just a few weeks, I find it quite promising. And you, when you decide to switch from Yuzu, will you choose Suyu or Sudachi? Remember that tomorrow I'll be conducting tests on Android between Yuzu, Suyu, and Sudachi. Thank you for your viewership, and until the next video.